Hey guys, I hope all is well with you guys. Of course, my name is Olena and welcome to the LA Chronicles. This is actually my second time recording this video. The sun started going down drastically while I was recording. So it went from being so light and airy and clear in the video to being so dark like that. So let's get with the program. I do want to let you guys know that I'm trying to see if I can do a FAQ video at least once a month or once every other month. Every other month or twice a month. If you have any questions that you would like for me to answer for you guys on video, because I'm not going to type back to every single person. That's going to be very difficult and it's going to be time consuming. Just go ahead and leave your questions below or go ahead and go onto my main page, my LA Chronicles page, my main page, click about. Then when you click about, on the lower left hand corner, you will see it say send message and you'll be able to send me a message. So let's get right into it. So do I have to retake the driving test? Of course, if you decide to switch your license, did I just say that? So if you are an honorable human being and follow the laws of our country and decide to change, to move to LA, you will have to change your driver's license. Will you have to retake the test? Not necessarily. My friends never retook the test, but they retook the written test. All I ask for anyone that moves to LA to do is to learn to parallel park. That is very important. Very important to learn how to parallel park. Because if you don't know how to parallel park, you are shit out of grass when you come here. Or shit out of luck when you come here. Because 99.9% of the time, you will have to parallel park. It's hard to get around it. Like when I'm in Miami, I don't have to parallel park. When I'm in Orlando, I don't have to parallel park. But here in LA, every single day, I have to parallel park. There's no getting around it. And when I moved here with my car, I had to learn how to parallel park like this. And the first few times, it was a little hard. Then after that, I got used to it. But yes, you will have to retake the driver's test. Every single person I know had to redo the driving test. Can you rent an apartment without a job? I moved here when I was 21 years old and I had a lot of money saved in a bank and I was able to rent an apartment. So anyone can rent an apartment without a job. But the main thing is that you need to have money somewhere. Where is your money coming from? Your bank account. That's where your money's gonna come from. So you need to be able to have enough money saved up. Like I've told you guys before, make sure that you have at least 6 months to a year's rent saved up. Saved up, but even then, with that being about $12,000, have at least $15,000 saved in the bank. Why? Because yes, if anything could happen, anything could happen. I've seen people living on the street because something happened. You want the actual building manager or the owner of the building, you want them to be able to give you the benefit of the doubt because of the fact is, hey, this guy had $15,000 saved. He is young or he's a little older, so he is responsible. You need to be able to have money saved in the bank. Do not move here if you don't have money saved in the bank. I'm letting you know that right now. I don't know how people do it. Unless you have your mom or your dad and your cousin, your great aunt or somebody living here, do not move here without money saved in the bank. Because again, you're not moving in with me. Now, somebody asked, because he's been to LA a few times. His wife has never been to LA. And he wants to know what he can do for his wife. His wife has acted in the past and she's done some temporary work. What I can tell some of you guys that might have a little bit difficulties finding work because of any reason, learn Excel, learn how to type, and learn PowerPoint. And please be able to construct a decent sentence. Learn how to be able to speak professionally. Of course, leave Ebonics at home and learn how to speak professionally. If you know how to write a decent sentence, if you know PowerPoint, if you know Excel, you can do temp work. Temp work you can find all the time. You can get a temp work for 2 weeks Then it can get you another job and another job and another job. Temp work is easy to get here in LA. I have done it in the past. My friends have done it in the past. But I wish that I have stayed consistent with it. But the thing is that I hate working for the man. I hate working for people. Period, point blank. Period, point blank. Now, let's get into it. Somebody asked me about me doing background, doing market research, selling on Amazon, selling on Craigslist, selling on eBay. Once upon a time, I did sell on eBay. I don't sell on eBay no more. I did sell on Amazon. I don't sell on Amazon anymore. I don't sell on Craigslist. I've sold things on Craigslist in the past. Selling on Craigslist is a bit dangerous. I've known people that has gotten beaten up meeting people at Starbucks to sell a phone. I don't do that. I'd rather not sell my phone at all, or sell it on Poshmark, or sell it on eBay, or sell it on some website where I'm going to be able to, and I just mail it to you. Because, you know, some people are gangster. They really want this iPhone, so they'll beat the shit out of you for this iPhone. But yeah, I've sold on Amazon. I've sold eyelashes on Amazon. I've sold makeup on Amazon. I sold some things. Mostly things that I've sold has been beauty related. Some people may know, or some people might not know. I am a makeup junkie, but I don't necessarily wear makeup, although I have it on right now. I only have it on because of video, but on an everyday basis. I'm a makeup junkie that don't wear makeup. So I was selling everything. Anything that Amazon would allow me to sell, I will sell. Yes, I sold books as well. If you have it in you to run an actual online store, go ahead and do so. I don't sell on eBay anymore because eBay fees are too heavy for me. They're too much. They've changed their policy, but I'm not into selling on eBay anymore. But I still sell on Etsy. I do make jewelry from time to time when I find the chance, when I find the time. I do sell on Etsy. I do make jewelry from time to time when I get the time. But I do have my own online website, what I'm going to make public today for you guys. Clothinglust.com. The link will be below. All of my handmade products will be under Shop Accomplice. Shop accessories. Accomplice means accessories. If you guys want to know. So support. If you see anything you want on there, go there. Mostly what I have in there now is makeup, eyelashes. I have some bags. I have some shirts. Or I have a shirt, a bag, all brand new. And I'm going to be selling lots and lots and lots and lots of jewelry, lots and lots and lots of clothes. But that's in time, probably around June. My store is going to be fully stocked. But yeah, you can if you like selling online, if that's your thing, find vendors, make stuff. If you're good with your hands, make something and sell it. If you are good with hair, do someone hair, make some money. If you're a graphic designer, design. Do what you need to do to make money. There's always ways out there to make money. I truly hope that you guys enjoyed the video. If you haven't checked out part one, make sure you go ahead and do so. I answer so many more questions that I didn't answer on here. I'm planning to do this possibly once per month so I can answer your questions personally. Anyway, shameless plug, make sure you go ahead and visit clothinglust.com where you will see everything that I have for sale. Free shipping until May of 2014 for all United States customers. Peace!